Hi guys, I continue with a teardown of a big laser jet printer. So first, about this belt, I did remove the remaining piece. And actually there is a rubber belt stuck onto it on each side. But on this flat piece, here I did cut with scissors, but there is no junction. So it looks like it is an extruded piece of plastic, quite interesting. On the other side we have some kind of white indexes, so there must be some optical sensor somewhere picking them up. Okay, so about the teardown, where to start? I think I will start with this stupid green plate at the bottom for removing paper jams, which seems very delicate. In fact, so it looks like so from the bottom. We have one piece here for structural executive, probably. So this green piece, in fact, you're supposed to remove it like so somewhere, to remove your paper jam. And if you want to remove the piece, you just have to disengage two plastic things and then somehow try to get it out like so. So we have little paper rolls, a spring mounted loaded thing, some steel to separate here for recycling, and we have these two plastic pieces, one on the other side probably also, or maybe it is here. So it is a kind of pieces you may want to keep for repairing maybe other printers, maybe they are used in several models. So this will be probably totally a useless part. Okay, now that it is done, let's start at the rear side. Why not? Oops. Okay, so at this rear side, I will remove this rear cover. So like so, we have here some kind of plasticky piece. Excuse me, I'll move the camera a little bit. Like so, I guess it will be good. We have this cutting around, some kind of a paper guide assembly. It is just one screw, so it looks like it is a filled easy replacement piece, because there is this roller here which may get worn out. Apart from this, nothing interesting in here. It will go to the recycling. So first screw off. We have here this piece which seems to be quite complicated, and I do not know how it is attached exactly for now. Oh, I can see a clip at the bottom here. Maybe if I remove this on the other side also. Other side there is a plastic retainer thing and one other clip. Okay, here we are. So more paper feeding stuff. And now I have this back cover. In fact, I have two screws to undo, and it will allow to slide it off, I believe, like so. Yes, easy enough. So on all these parts, in fact, it will require further disassembly because you have some small stuff to undo. So I will put them aside. It will probably not be on camera because it is not interesting. But for recycling and parts salvaging purpose, I will process it them later. So we are left here with this flippy hinge thing. And it seems we just have plastic clips to pop off. Try to. Maybe. Or break like this. This one went correctly. And now I can undo. You have always to find the correct position to undo the parts. There is in fact a notch in them, like so. So if you align them correctly, they will come off, but it is not a position in which it could be normally located when in service. So this is interesting. So most printers are done this way. So here we have one other piece, which may be coming like this. One more. This one is more or less still attached, but this one is good to go. And so in here we have a fan, but so far I do not see how to remove the fan. Yes, but not how to remove this piece. So it will be a little bit annoying, I guess. Or maybe it will come off with this wall plastic assembly. Not sure. So I will leave it alone for now. And there is one plastic assembly that can undo here. But I did already investigate a little bit for the disassembly process. So there is just this plastic cover, and at several points I did notice this metal things in the plastic piece. So there must be contributing signals on making contact with some parts, probably. Okay, so I am annoyed with this thing really, because it is totally in the way, excuse me. Trying to figure out how to undo it. Oh, I think it must be located somewhere at the bottom here. In fact, I see two screws, but they will not be easy to access for now, so I will be leave it alone, maybe attach it with a zip tie or something. Okay, so that was the rear panel. Let's try to flip it around and process the same way for the front access door, like so. I will adjust the camera, align the things properly. So this just a sub part of this. I have what seems to be a retainer piece on the side. I guess this piece must be filled replaceable if in case someone breaks it. Not Brexit. Brexit, you want to be able to repair it. It's very fun. This is probably not the correct way, but it is working, so I will not complain. I see here a plastic piece I can bend more or less, and here we are. Oh, it was not too difficult, in fact, and we have a nice metal rod here. I will save all these parts, go to the recycling. Let me deal with the spring in here. Okay. So now it is coming in a lot of parts, so to be recycled. But here I can save the LaserJet logo. I did already prepare plastic bag to put the trash like so. Okay. So it is good news. A lot of progress in not even 15 minutes. So where is this thing here? It is still attached. I will just, there are three screws here. Get rid of it. Okay. So more sub-assemblies. Recycling. And now we can start to attack the interesting parts. Like this left panel, right panel, rather. So under this panel we actually have most of the electronics. Well, a part of electronics at least. This was easy enough. So we anodize the plastic freed or self-tapping screws in this thing are really easy to undo. But the other screws with metal freed, threaded in metal if you prefer, are sometimes very, very hard. Okay, so big piece off. We have a first view inside. So, two rotors. I do not know what they are turning exactly. Some kind of auxiliary board. Interface board, it seems. This seems to be a USB cable, probably going to the Wi-Fi module somewhere. Flat flex. I guess behind here we may have the power supply. And what else? A fan. Which I will undo later. Okay. So when this is done, I can actually undo the top cover. And this will be interesting to look at. One screw here, and in fact it is all because I did already remove a part over it, and there we are, easy enough, top cover piece, one more giant piece of plastic, and we have a view to the engine, laser engine, and more electronics. How to proceed like this? No, it is not easy. I will put the camera over it. Like so. So you have here the laser engine with a yellow sticker. I do not know if we have one or three or four lasers in this. We have here a PCB which is probably the main processing PCB. Because lots of cables going to it and lots of flat flex. On the right side here, we have what seems to be the Wi-Fi module. Front panel here. So what to do next? Let me think a little bit. We can undo this front piece. Should be easy. And then we will try to find how to remove the left side. And I think it will wrap this video for today. So, here, this to align it properly, more or less. So we have what seems to be one screw. Oh. We want to undo here. Well, it is still attached somehow. Oh, there is another screw in here. So in fact, even this control panel is designed to be replaced in the field, it seems. It is just a few screws. And here we have this panel with a power button. It should be exactly the same deal. I guess we have more screws hidden somewhere. No, I do not see anyone. Maybe behind this or the bottom, no. So in fact, searching for the correct disassembly procedure sometimes take more time than the disassembly itself. So it looks like it is all retained in place by the power switch. So what I will do for now, as I do not know exactly where it will go, I will replace one screw and I will come back to that later. And now we can try to figure out how to remove this left side panel, which has no screw accessible from the outside, but oops, it is really not convenient, this thing, excuse me. But I have, focus please, one screw here at least at the top. So let's start with it. So maybe it will reveal a lot more electronics and stuff. Oh, it was easy enough. It looks like there is some kind of a plastic clip inside here. Yes, and as you can see, I was just saying before, maybe it will reveal more electronics. In fact, it does reveal a giant PCB. Taking the whole surface of the printer, it is 40 centimeters long and 20 centimeters wide. Quite amazing. In fact, I was not expecting something so big. See, so here I can see a thick wire loom, probably going to the oven unit, which must be this here on the top, and you may not see, it is perfectly out of frame here. There is a wall flat flex responsible for transferring the image data, probably, to the processor board. I do not know exactly. We have gaps here in the PCB at the bottom. So we must have a high voltage for the corona wires generated at this area. Some MOSFETs, some special ICs probably. And what I guess I wanted to show you again also what it looks like inside without the transfer belt. If I can turn this thing. So here is what we have inside. In fact, we have several times the same assembly. They are spring mounted, loaded things, and there are four of them. So I guess these parts do press the transfer belt against the drum, image drum from located in the toner cartridges. And it looks like there are some wires and electronics inside also. So it will probably be quite interesting to look at it. But first I will need to figure out what to take apart next, because as you can see, it is a big mess loaded with stuff everywhere now. Parts everywhere, and it is not really easy to figure out where to continue. As you can see, so let me do a last turn around of this thing. So yes, the big fancy laser unit is here probably. I cannot see yet how many open windows we have. They are located in here. This is the failed unit. Big PCB on the left side. On the right, probably a big power supply behind this. And some interfaces bound. I do not think we have only two motors in this. This must be responsible for the making movement of the drum cartridges, the toner. So probably we have one more motor for the paper hidden somewhere, buried in the... Oh, I see one more motor here, actually. On the top, probably for the oven section. And there is stuff and wires everywhere. Maybe it should be a good photo for my Flickr, in fact, this naked printer. I may take photos of it before I take it apart further. Okay, thanks for watching so far. Bye bye.